In the last session, we were able to use the square root property to solving the equation like x plus 9 squared equal to 10. So because the left side was a perfect square, so very easy for apply the square root property for solving equation like this. But if the left hand side was a perfect square trinomial, you need to rewrite it in form of a plus b squared or a minus b squared in order to using the square root properties. Example, you got x squared plus 10x plus 25 equal to 9. So the left hand side we have a perfect square trinomial and the right hand side we got a constant number. The changing from x squared plus 10x plus 25, we can rewrite it in form of x plus 5 squared is equal to 9. After that, you can using square root property for solving this equation. But the process changing from the trinomial become to the perfect square, we call it completing the square. The fundamental theorem of completing the square is two identities, a plus b square and a minus b square. A plus b square equal to a square plus 2ab and plus b square. And a minus b square will be a square minus 2ab and plus b square. Let me make them more clearly. A plus b square in the left hand side is perfect square, but in the right hand side you got trinomial. When I say about trinomial, it means expression will have three terms. The first term will be a square, the last term will be b square, and the middle term will be the product of two a and b. If you got m plus b and square outside, the first term will be 3m square and the last term will be b square. And the middle term you got 2m multiply b. And it's the same way for a minus b square equal to trinomial in the right hand side. A square in the first term, b square in the last term, and the middle is minus 2ab. Example, you got a minus d square. The first term will be a square, the last term will be d square, and the middle term will be 2 minus 2ad. So here is the application of two identity. You will be using the two identity for completing the square of expression x squared plus 6x. Since there's a plus sign between the two terms, so we will use the a plus b identity but changing sign. When I say changing sign, I mean the trinomial will be left hand side and the perfect square will be right hand side. Comparing the position of each term for two expression, you will be determining a and b. Example, you got a square plus 2ab and plus b square here, and in the below you got a square plus 6x. We start with determining a. Notice that the first term of a square plus 6x is a square here. This tells us that x will be a. And the middle term, you will got 2a and b. The middle term is 6x. In the form of 2ab, we need to find a number multiplied with 2x gives 6x. It could have to be 3. I mean, b have to be equal to 3. Now we find the last term b square of trinomial, which is b square. We got here is a square plus 2xb, and you need add 2 b square here. The last term of this expression will be b square. So b equal to 3. I mean, b square will be equal to 9. And you can rewrite totally like 2x multiply 3 and plus 3 square. X plus 3 square outside, I mean completing the square totally. That is a fundamental theorem about completing the square for helping you get more understanding. But here is the way you can choose for solving your working in your notebook. You got a square plus 6x in one expression, and it will be changing become to a square plus 2 multiply x and multiply 3. Because the b is 3 in this position, so we figure out the last term will be b square. But in the original expression, we have no 3 square. We add with 3 square in the second step, we should minus 3 square in the second step, and they combine equal to 0 for unchanging the expression. The first three term of expression will be factor become to completing the square, and we rewrite my negative 3 square here, and the factor become to completing the square, and this bracket will be equal to x plus 3 and square outside and minus 9. We got minus 9 here because we have minus 3 squared in this position. Another example, we got x squared plus 8h, and x squared will be added with 2x, and which number multiplied with 2x give 8x? We get 4. So we determine the last term will be 4 squared. We add with 4 squared here, you should minus 4 squared because the original have no 4 squared. And you can combine the first 3 terms become 2x plus 4 squared and rewrite minus 16. Understood? So here is the last example before we stop this video. We got x squared plus 10x will be equal to x squared plus 2 multiply x and multiply 5. I mean the last term will be 5 squared, and we add 5 squared, we minus 4 5 squared for unchanging the expression. The first 3 terms will be combined together and you got x plus 5 and square outside and minus 25 here. I hope this video can help you get more understanding about the completing the square, and if you like, you can share, subscribe. Thank you so much for watching.